Hello everyone! In this video we are going to learn about the various parts of a circle and what they are called. Let's start. A circle is a perfectly round, flat, two-dimensional shape like this one. The line that marks the edge of a circle is called the circumference. If the circumference is not complete, then the circle becomes an arc. This is an arc. The point in the middle of the circle is called the center. The distance from the center to the circumference is called the radius. It is usually marked off by an arrow like so. And this is an example of how the radius is dimensioned. When the circle is too small to dimension in this way, we write the dimension on the outside like so. Twice the radius is called the diameter. It is marked by a line going through the center and having an arrow at each end, like so. This is how a diameter is dimensioned. Note the symbol before the dimension. That is the diameter symbol. Similar to the diameter, there is the chord. It is a line that goes from one point to another point on the circumference of the circle, but it does not go through the center. Related to the chord is what we call the segment. While the chord is just a line, the segment is the area that has been cut by that line. If the chord that parts the segment is a diameter, because it goes through the center of the circle, then this special segment is called a semicircle. A sector is a part of a circle bound by two radii and the arc that joins them. If the angle between the two radii is exactly 90 degrees, then the special sector is called a quadrant. And finally, a tangent is a line that touches the circle at only one point, without going into the circle. If a line is drawn from the center of the circle to the point of tangency, then this line is called a normal. A normal and a tangent are always perpendicular, which means at 90 degrees to each other. That is all for this video. Thanks for watching and good luck with your drawing.